Since 2020, our team is developing the evoBOT. When we had the idea for the evoBOT, we wanted to develop a mobile robot for logistics that could lift packages from any height. But it should also be able to manipulate packages by rotating them or placing them upside down. This allows already to accomplish a variety of tasks. In addition, it should do it fast. However, the robot should be simple to some extent, with a minimum count on actuators and only as big as necessary for its task with a small footprint. This requirement actually stems from the fact that we are a department that origins from the development of microelectronic devices, where we aim to make circuit boards as small as possible and make the best use of the available space.
Our selected hardware components aims to generate high dynamics of the overall system and also to achieve a robust robot platform that can perform multiple tasks in different environments. Depending on the carrying load and the configuration of the robot, its possible tilt angle covers almost 180 degrees. A 360 degree camera is an elegant solution to cope with this constraint. That's why we use the 360 degree camera for localization here. In order to run the computationally intensive SLAM algorithms, we use a high-performance NVIDIA Jetson AGX development board. In addition, we followed a new approach for the vehicle by not using standard components anymore. Instead, we developed tailor-made solutions ourselves, like perfectly tuned control boards, PCBs, electrical slip rings, just to mention a few examples here.
We designed the chassis of evoBOT to be both very strong and likewise simple. We paid special attention to minimize the number of hollow spaces and keep the overall size small, resulting in an optimized use of space. Another key aspect of our design is modularity. With just a few steps, we can completely detach the arm from the rest of the structure and mount other grippers or similar devices at the shoulder joints. Due to the intentionally simple design, we initially opted not to use springs and dampers. However, this is not an issue for a normal factory environment, and the typical unevenness found there can be overcome.